Hi guys, welcome to the first WPH Workout Wednesday, coming live from Ballydesmond in County Cork. I'm delighted to be the first player to take on the challenge of doing a live home workout. Also slightly terrified, but look, it's a bit of fun anyway. So yeah, I see some comments already. I'd love lots of comments so I don't feel like I'm totally talking to myself. Let me know where you are watching from, if you're by yourself or if there's somebody from your household maybe joining in with you. If not, I'll be your workout buddy for the evening. Well, it's 7 o'clock in Ireland anyway, so wherever you are. So basically the layout is going to be a quick dynamic warm-up. We're going to do a HIIT workout. It's going to be 2 7.5 minute blocks. I'll explain a bit more once we've done our warm-up. We're going to do a quick core finisher, and then we are going to do a yoga inspired warm-up, which I'm excited to share. I did yoga as my handball at home clip for the WPH Instagram page, so I feel pretty passionate about that one. So let me know as well how the volume is, if I'm shouting at you, if you can hear me or not, that'd be great. Okay, so let's get warmed up. We're gonna start sitting down. If you have a mat, that's great. I told you no equipment necessary though. We're gonna spread our legs, clasp our hands behind our head, and we're gonna take some side bends. So let's just go 3 each side. So elbow to knee, if you can. This feels nice, warm up my back, side of my body and the groin area as well. Perfect. Great, okay, let's take it up into tabletop and we're gonna do some cat-cows. So I'm going to drop my belly and lift my chin up to the ceiling, and then I'm gonna push through the floor through my hands. Exhale, round your back and bring your chin into your chest. So let's do 3 good ones as well. Inhale, exhale, push and round. Inhale, drop, exhale. One more, inhale, and exhale, push. Great, okay, let's raise our right arm and our left leg, so opposite, so get our core engaged. We're gonna be doing some core work during our HIIT workout and the finisher, like I said. So reach out and keep breathing through it.
The Walshes in Mallow are watching.
Hi to the Walshes in Mallow. Great to have a Cork representation.
Ashley loves the chains.
Ashley O'Keefe. Thanks, Ashling, for your feedback. I have my sister here hiding under the laptop telling me who's commenting. So she's behind the scenes. So we're going to take it down onto our belly and we're going to do the same thing. Raise your right hand and your left leg and then swap. Great, let's take it onto our backs this time. And we're gonna start rolling. So 2 hands down by your side, palms into the floor. We're gonna try to bring our legs up over our heads, then straighten them down and touch your toes if you can, or as far as you can. Touch your shins if you want. So you can take it nice and gentle for the first few rocks. Just warming up our muscles, and in a minute we're going to try to get our heart rate up as well. Okay, let's take it up onto our feet and we're going to do some walkouts. So you can have a slight bend in your knees, hands down onto the floor, walk out to plank and then back up. So when you get to standing, you're going to squeeze your glutes. Back down for 2 more. Hope everyone's having a nice day so far. It was another lovely sunny day here. Great, okay. So we're gonna do 3 bodyweight squats. 1, 2, 3. Okay, now we're gonna take it down wide leg position for a yogi squat. So I'm using my elbows to push my knees out. Get comfortable there. Left hand down, right hand up. So hi to Maureen Casey, all the way in Boston. My cousin, always great to support me. It's a pity we didn't make it to New York, to the NYAC this year, but there'll be more years, more chances. Okay, and finally, we're gonna jog on the spot. And when I say go, we're gonna sprint on the spot. So we're gonna get our hands going and obviously our feet going faster as well. Just for a count of three, I'll count us down. Okay, go. 3, 2, 1, and jog. Go. 3, 2, 1. Let's do one more. Go. 3, 2, and 1. Great. Well, I can't see you, but I'm sure you're doing great. So I'm going to get a quick drink. I hope everybody's warmed up.
Ashlyn Donahue, Eva Flanagan.
Hi, Ashlyn, Eva, all my girls from college. Okay, now we're going to do a HIIT workout. So I'm going to set my timer. We're going to work for 35 seconds, so intense, going to push ourselves. Then we're going to rest for 15 seconds and move on to the next exercise. So like I said, two different blocks. Each block has three exercises. So I'll quickly demonstrate them now and then we'll get stuck in. So the first exercise is cross climber to toe touch. So we're going to get into plank. Bring your right knee to your left elbow, left knee to right elbow, then come back and touch either toe, so opposite. So opposite, opposite. Okay, that's our first exercise. Second exercise, some more running on the spot, although we're moving laterally a little bit. So we're sprinting, but we just go slightly left and right each time. Okay, and then the last one is going to be a reverse lunge into a hop. I'll tell you when we're halfway through the time so that you can swap to the other leg. So if you want, you can modify that slightly depending on how your knees are. So reverse lunge and knee drive. So this foot is staying on the floor in that case, or just a reverse lunge and step up. Okay, so those are our three options. Hope you're ready. We're gonna start in 5 seconds. And go, cross, cross, toe touch. We can all push ourselves to our own level. So some of you probably going faster than me, that's totally fine. Let's just try to challenge ourselves. And sprinting. Sometimes 35 seconds goes quickly, sometimes it doesn't. Side to side, we have a lot of side to side movement in handball, most sports really. Last 5, keep pushing. And break. Sometimes I forget to breathe. Deep breath, reverse lunge and hop. I'm starting on my right leg. Remember, I'll tell you when to swap. Nice explosive movement.
We're
flying through it. Hi, Noreen. Right. Back to our first exercise. Noreen was my guinea pig the other day to try out Facebook Live because I had never done it before and didn't have a clue. Don't necessarily intend doing it again. That's fine. Keep going. And break. Good job.
Ash and Kerry want to stand and peg.
Ash and Kerry, I hope you're joining in.
Joan and Shabina.
I hope Reed and Martin are joining in. Dan and Peg are hiding in the kitchen. We're upstairs, so it probably sounds like the ceiling is about to cave in. Shout out to my brother for use of his bedroom, actually. The tiniest room in the house. And he's over in Sydney, so it's the middle of the night. But he tells me he'll watch tomorrow, so we'll see. Last 10. I'm slacking off. Keep going. And break. Good job. The reverse lunge is next. Don't usually work out this late in the evening. I hope nobody's just after their dinner. Reverse and hop. So use your arms to drive back, then you hop. And swap. Keep forgetting that part. Two, one. Great, that's the first block done.
Donna and Shanae are doing great.
Hi, Donna and Shanae as well.
And Sinead Foley.
And Sinead, my other guinea pig. Okay, we're not going to break for long, guys. We're going to keep going. I need a quick drink. Hope you're finding it challenging enough so far. I think this next block might be a bit tougher. But it depends. I try to include some exercises that I like doing and some that aren't my favourites. Just try to challenge myself as much as possible.
Eleanor is taking a break.
Hi, Eleanor. And Orla's watching too. Great to have support from my school team. And I miss you all.
Maureen, please, it's snowing where she is.
It's snowing. Well, we've had a lot of sunshine here lately, which is probably making it harder for people to stay at home. But we know that that's all we got to do. The bigger picture is more important. It's nice to get out for a little walk every day, though. My mother is mad for walking, so there's no fear that we wouldn't. Okay. So same format again, 35 seconds work, 15 rest. I'm just using an app on my phone. It's called Tabata Timer. I find it very good. It's free. Okay, so let me demonstrate the next three exercises. That part's probably important. So we're going to do a spider climber. So this time, our left hand is coming towards our left foot is coming towards our left hand, and vice versa. But we're going to try to hop to transition. So we're going to do 1, 2, 3, 4, up, 180 degree turn, back down, 1, 2, 3, 4. Try to stay down and do your turn. Okay, that's the first one. The next one is a wall sit. So put your back up against the wall or the door in my case. Walk your feet out. You want to try to make a 90 degree angle with your legs if you can. If you want, you can bring it up a bit higher and that's a bit easier, okay? I said no equipment, but if you wanted to add some weight here, maybe a medicine ball or a heavy book to challenge yourself more. And then last one, everybody's favorite. We're going to do a burpee. A burpee tuck jump, okay? So, chest to floor, up, bring your knees up. So, I try to touch my ankles. You can try to touch your shins if you want, either. Okay, modifications would be half burpee, tuck jump, or half burpee, regular jump, or stepping out and stepping in. Okay, so lots of options. Everybody ready? Yeah, everybody's ready.
We're good to go.
Okay, first exercise are spider climbers. Starting in 5 seconds. Down. 1, 2, 3, 4. Stay down. Turn. 1, 2, 3, 4. Hey, So, yeah, so HIIT training is just like circuit training. Duxie would be the first person. Let's go, Wilfit, to introduce me to circuit training. When I was 14, I've learned to enjoy it more over the years. Still just as hard, probably, but I embrace it more, embrace the sweat. So try not to put your hands on your legs. Put them out in front. Bend your head. Cross your arms. We've got burpees coming up next. And break. Yeah, I'm finding exercise it's giving my day more structure at the moment, which is good. We usually work out at the same time every day. Okay, spider climbers.
No.
Oh, burpees. I was subconsciously trying to skip them. Okay, so I think I got 10. So I'm gonna try to get 10 next round as well. We'll see.
Vincent says very professional.
Thanks, Evie. Spider climbers. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. Turn. Turn. Last 10. Okay, my last hop, my last turn was very lethargic. Going again in 3. Wall sit.
They're going very quiet.
That's a good sign that they're quiet. It means they're working. Yeah, so I'm sure we all miss playing handball at the moment, but we'll be back. We can work on our fitness at the moment. And the WPH Patreon are giving us lots of great content, footage that we can study. Try to keep our handball brains in check. And break. Barkley's coming up. Then we'll have 2 rounds done. And go. Almost there, guys. Last 10. It's hard to talk at the same time, okay? Go on, sis, last one. This is a good one. We're getting our breath back. We're still working our legs. By round three now, we might be feeling it a bit more of a shake. Last three. And shake out your legs. Last round of burpees. Usually Marie does join me and it helps me push myself. Go! Favorite exercises were maybe the ones you found the toughest, but I'm gonna take another quick break, then we're gonna do our core finisher. So I'm just gonna adjust my timer. This time we're gonna do 2 minutes non-stop, four different exercises, 30 seconds each. I'll tell you when we're moving on to the next one. Okay, I'm gonna need a drink, then I'll demonstrate. And then I promise the cool down is nice and relaxing. I hope you're sweating too.
Don't have no more burpees.
No more burpees, no. Okay, we're lying on our backs. We're gonna try to keep our back flat against the mat. So not arching. We're gonna start off with regular leg lifts, two legs at once. If your flexibility allows, try to keep your legs straight and then bring them down a couple of inches off the floor each time. Then we're gonna switch to single leg lifts. So I'm gonna drop the left down, bring it back up, drop the right down, back up, and then lift my hips off the mat. Down, down, lift. Okay? Then we're going to do slow bicycle crunches. Slow bicycle crunches. So opposite elbow to opposite knee. Nice and controlled. And then the last one is going to be butterfly sit-ups. So I'm going to put my feet together, bring myself up, and touch the floor in between my feet. So I will remind you, there's different variations for the crunches as well. If you want, have your knees bent and just slide your hands up and down, but try not to hurt your neck, basically. Just whatever feels comfortable. Okay, we're starting in 5 seconds with our leg lifts. Hope everyone's ready. 3, 2, 1, go. We're just doing each of these exercises once. Last 5. Then we're swapping to single leg. 2 feet up, drop your left, Drop your right. Lift your hips. Left. Right. Lift. So we want to keep our core engaged. Remember, back flat. And swap bicycles. Bend those knees. Keep breathing through it. I'm really feeling this one. 10 seconds. And last exercise, butterfly sit-ups. Halfway. Last few reps, make them count. Last one. My mat has totally changed position since I lay down on it. Okay, quick drink. I'm gonna take the tempo down for a cool down. Please hang in there for a cool down. So like I said, it's gonna be yoga inspired. I'm not an expert, but I do try to do a yoga flow. At the moment, since quarantine, we've been doing it daily, just for about half an hour. But I find it really just benefits my body in terms of flexibility and mobility and my mind as well. It's a form of mindfulness, really. So we don't need to be able to do anything fancy like the splits or anything half that impressive. So basically, if you can breathe and stretch, you're doing yoga.
Katrina Duffy's abs are on fire.
Good, Katrina Duffy. I'm glad. Mine are on fire as well. That's what we want. Okay. Quick drink.
Jean Thompson feels in good result and catch it.
Hi Jean, hope you're well. Okay, so if you have a mat, we're gonna start towards the front of our mat. You can have a slight bend in your knees and we're gonna take it for a forward fold. So we're just gonna let our bodies get heavy, touch the floor if you can, or as close to it as you can. We're gonna take a halfway lift, so hands onto our shins, chest up. Back down. Now we're gonna grab our opposite elbows for ragdoll. It's one of my favorites. We can gently rock side to side. Shake out your head. Yes and no. Hands back down, and we're gonna take a big step backwards with our right foot into a lunge. Drop your back knee, untuck your back toes for a low lunge. I'm gonna take my left hand to my left knee and look over my left shoulder. Nice deep breaths. I'm gonna straighten that front leg, sit back and fold down over it, flex your front toes and back up to our lunge. So we're gonna flow through that two more times. Bend, straighten, bend again. Great. Now we're going to stretch our quads. So reach back with your left hand, with your right hand, and grab your right leg if it's comfortable. Drop that back down. Going to pop back up onto our back foot. Take your left elbow down to your left foot and then reach up. Let's do three. Okay. Well done. Let's step our left foot back and we're going to go into down dog. So press your hips into the air. We want our heels to be going towards the ground. Nice calf stretch. Pedal. So walk it out, bend into your left, straighten your right, and swap. Let's gently drop down onto our knees and we're going to do the puppy pose. So we're in tabletop. We're going to walk our hands out. Our hips are still high and let your forehead melt into the mat. I love this one on my back. Slowly come back up. Down dog. We're going to slowly walk our feet up to our hands. Back to ragdoll, grab your elbows. And we're going to repeat that on our left side now. So hands down, up to our shins, halfway lift. Big step back with our left. Drop your knee, untuck your toes. Take your right hand to your right knee and look over your right shoulder. So next, straighten that front leg, flex your toes, fold over it, and back to our low lunge. So repeat two more times. Keep breathing. Good job. Okay, next, if you want, take your left hand and grab your left foot. Nice stretch for your quad. Back down. Up onto your back toes, take your right elbow down to your right foot, and open up. Good job. Hands back down, back to plank, back to down dog. And let's drop down to our knees. So we're back in tabletop. And let's lift our left hand up. We're going to thread the needle. So follow with your eyes. Thread it through under your right arm and let your head melt down again. So your hips are going to want to follow that arm. So try to actively resist that. In this case, I'm trying to push my hips to the left so I feel more of a stretch. Let's come back up and thread it one more time. Might be able to go a bit further with your stretch this time. Great. Before we do the other side, let's do Sphinx pose. So down onto your belly. And we're going to lift up onto our forearms. And lift up your chin. Well done. Push back onto our knees, back to tabletop. We're going to repeat on the other side. So right hand up, follow with your eyes, thread it through, push your hips to the right. One more time, up with your arm, thread it through. Great job. So this is another one of my favorites. We're almost there now, I promise. So child's pose. Gonna take a wide leg child's pose. So walk out your arms, walk out your hands, let your head melt into the mat. Walk your hands over to the left. Back to the middle. And walk over to the right. Great. Now we're going to do a nice stretch for the front of our ankles. So those tuck jumps were high impact on our ankles. We're going to stay in this position. I'm going to put my hands behind me to support me. And I'm going to lift my shins off the mat. That's quite intense for me. I'm going to drop them down. Go one more time. Great. Let's take it onto our backs. Knees bent. Lift up your right foot straight. And we're going to do some ankle rotations. Do both directions, clockwise and anti-clockwise. Then I'm going to bend that across my left leg. Push that right knee away. Feel a stretch on your glute. Make that more intense. You can clasp your hands behind your left hamstring and pull it in. And let's repeat on the other side. So left leg up, rotate your ankle. Just heard a pop. It's okay. It's a good pop. Okay, bend it across your right leg. Push away your knee. Clasp behind your hamstring and pull it in. Okay, drop it down. Let your left leg go down straight and hold your right knee into your chest. And then I'm going to do a spinal twist. So bring that across your body to the left, follow with your arm, and then open up. Find this one relaxing. Okay, back to middle, other side. Holding your left knee. Bring it across your body, follow with your arm, and then open up. Good stuff. Back to your middle. Okay, we're going to do happy baby. So you're going to grab your feet, or you can grab your calves if you want. We're taking our legs wide, and we're going to rock side to side. Let's straighten out our right leg and bend our left and opposite. Let's curl up into a ball. This time bring your elbow towards your knee. Hug it in tight. And we're going to just let everything drop. So arms down by your side for our final resting pose, Shavasana. Let your feet flop open. Let's take three really slow, deep breaths here. Into your nose. Out to your mouth. Bring some movement back in, so wriggle your fingers, wriggle your toes, and we can gently come back up, and we're done. So hope you enjoyed it. Stay tuned next week on the page for another workout from another one of the WPH players. I believe David Fink is going to be coming live from Tucson, so I'm really looking forward to that. He has unbelievable fitness levels and strength, so I'm glad I got to go before him in a way. So thanks very much for watching. Enjoy the rest of your day wherever you are. Thanks for all the comments and everything. You guys are so supportive. So bye from Bally Desmond.